And staying with our story, National President of the Bahujan Samaj Party or the BSP, Mayawati, has said, and I quote, that the order issued by the UP and Uttarakhand governments to the traders on the covered route to prominently display the full names of the owners and the staff of their shops and to ban the sale of meat is completely unconstitutional, and this is only being done for electoral gains. In fact, the attempt to economically boycott people of a particular religion in this manner is highly reprehensible and condemnable. Anshul, so very strong words coming in from Mayawati, but similar voices coming in from the opposition as well, that this order is not meant to respect the sentiments of the pilgrimage, but it's actually being done to target, a certain community, the Muslim community. Tell us a little bit more about the order that has been given and what are you seeing around you, given that you're there in the area. Have the owners started changing the boardings, because the UP government has mandated them to reveal the identity of the owners?
This is something that can be seen on the ground. All the restaurant owners are placed outside their restaurant. Name of the property very, very clearly mentioned. And as I just showed you, that owners have also gone a step further and have displayed the identity of each and every worker that is on play over here. But yes, there is members of the Muslim community that are being affected by this, because a lot of restaurant owners have gone ahead and sent them on forced leave for the next 15 to 20 days till the time this Kavad Yatra is going on, which means that somewhere or the other, these people, the people from the Muslim community who have been working in these restaurants for a very, very long time, somewhere or the other, they have lost their jobs, they have lost their daily wages, and this is something that has hampered their life. But if you speak to the owners over here, they say that during this time, especially during the time of Kavad Yatra, the roads are closed for traffic, which means that the number of people entering these restaurants, the footfall actually falls for the next 1 month, and hence they are not able to pay the entire staff. So somewhere or the other, the decision that has been taken by them is benefiting them, but definitely the people from that particular Muslim community are being asked to leave their jobs, return back to their homes over the next 15 to 20 days. This is something that is badly affecting them and their families as well.
This raging issue, let's listen in.
नकवी सर, यू ट्वीटेड यस्टरडे, आपने पोस्ट भी किया था, क्या कन्फ्यूजन हो गया था? आज कुछ अलग आदेश आया है, कल कुछ और?
देखिए, एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट के एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन का सीमित दिशा निर्देश आया था, और उस सीमित दिशा निर्देश में कई तरह के कन्फ्यूजन और कंट्राडिक्शन थे, और अति उत्साह में कुछ कर्मचारियों और कुछ अधिकारियों ने जिस तरह की चीज़ें की उसको लेकर के हाहाकार मचा। आज राज्य की सरकार ने स्पष्टता के साथ दिशा निर्देश दिया है, और स्पष्ट है कि कांवड़ यात्रियों की शुचिता, सुरक्षा और सम्मान की दृष्टि से ये फैसला, ये दिशा निर्देश है, और इसका सम्मान सबको करना चाहिए। इस पर किसी तरह के कमनल कलर चढ़ाने की कोशिश नहीं होनी चाहिए।
लेकिन जिस तरह से जब ये फैसला आया कल, उसके बाद हमने देखा कि चाहे ओवैसी हैं या जावेद अख्तर हैं, कई तरह के जो लोग हैं उनकी स्टेटमेंट
कल जो कुछ भी उस समय हड़बड़ी में गड़बड़ियाँ हुई थी, उसका जो जिस तरह का आप लोगों ने दिखाया, नेशनल इंटरनेशनल मीडिया ने उसको बात का बतंगड़ बना के दिखाया, तो निश्चित तौर से लोगों को चिंता हुई थी। इसमें मैं ये नहीं मानता कि किसी ने अगर उस पर कोई चिंता व्यक्त की है तो वो राष्ट्रद्रोही है।
लेकिन इस तरह के कन्फ्यूजन की जरूरत क्यों हुई आपकी तरफ से भी, एक जो राजनीति?
कोई कन्फ्यूजन जरूरत नहीं थी। जो गड़बड़ उस वक्त हड़बड़ी में जो कुछ किया, और उसका जिस तरह से एक दिशा निर्देश को जो है वो बात का बतंगड़ बना, उसको लेकर के था, और आज की तारीख में स्पष्टता है। मैं मानता हूं कि अब किसी तरह की कमनल कन्फ्यूजन की कोशिश नहीं होनी चाहिए।
Anshul is with us. Anshul, one understands the dietary restrictions of these pilgrims during the pilgrimage, during the yatra, which involves the exclusion of non-vegetarian food. But the banning of non-vegetarian stalls along this route would also really impact and would result in financial losses for most of these vendors. Have the authorities, made for any alternative solutions or arrangements for these vendors who will have to close shop?